Welcome to Christmas in July VBS 2020. I'm Robin Johnson with FBC Azle. We're so excited to have you guys. Today we're going to have fun with crafts and games and all kinds of things. Our parents are going to have this at the end. This is a kit that's going to tell you everything you need to do. But first of all, let's get up and stand up and sing and dance.
Everybody say yes, yes, yes to VBS.
Jesus, and he came to save.
scripture memory for the day is, "For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost." Luke chapter 19, verse 10. Okay, you guys, you've heard it. Now read it with me. "For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost." Luke 19, 10. Now, let's watch a skit.
Last time on Back to Christmas Past.
Seriously, give me the phone. No more phone. No more video games. Not until the project's finished.
But Mom!
We have to write a report about the history of Christmas.
Guys, seriously, get it finished before I get back from work.
Yeah, we could like Google it. I bet something will come up.
Well, that was easy. Click it, Lizzie.
What are we looking at? Doc Gray reporting for duty.
Yeah, I'm gonna go call 911.
No, trust me. I'm gonna make sure you know exactly what Christmas is all about. To the Vanlorian!
Whoa, Doc. We're not in Texas anymore.
This is Nazareth. It's where Jesus grew up. We're actually here to see when Mary first finds out about Jesus.
Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you. You will conceive and give birth to a son. You will name him Jesus.
I'm gonna have God's son. I have to go tell everyone.
See, guys, Jesus was not just any ordinary, normal person. He was God's very son.
Wait, is that it? Are we going home now?
No, we have many more things to see. To the Vanlorian!
All right, Doc, where are we off to next?
Ooh! Can we go see the dinosaurs? Or the flood? Or go to the moon? Oh, I've always wanted to jump on the moon.
We haven't got time for that, Marty!
Marty?
Marty?
I'm sorry, Jacob. You remind me of somebody I know named Marty. Well, anyways. So we just saw Gabriel announce to Mary that she was going to give birth to the Son of God. A short time after that, her and Joseph had to travel to their hometown of Bethlehem for a census.
What's a census?
Well, it's sort of a government headcount. Where they send you letter after letter after letter after letter until you finally cave in and do it.
Man, a census sounds horrible.
Oh, it is. Anyways, so they're on this long journey. And I say we go and check in on him. Let's get going!
Not this again!
You lost. We're lost, aren't we? I know you should have asked that beet farmer a few miles back.
I'm not lost. I know exactly where we are. I just need to figure out which way is north.
If we're not lost, then why have we passed that oak tree three times?
We've passed it three times? I mean, of course we've passed it three times. We're taking the scenic route. I need to figure out where we are.
Wow, they look stressed. How long have they been traveling, Doc?
Oh, about 12 hours now.
12 hours? They didn't even have video games to pass the time. Man, I'm so glad I was born in the 21st century. That must have been rough.
Yeah, this trip would have been rough for anybody, let alone someone that's pregnant and about to have a baby.
Oh, that's true. We should go help them.
Wait! No! Listen! Get down! We can't interact with them. If we change anything in history, it could have cataclysmic repercussions. Look, we have to make sure not to change anything. Got it?
Got it.
But one thing I don't understand is why Mary would go through all this. Why not just say no to the angel? It seems like it would have been a lot easier.
I'm glad you asked that, Lizzie. I think Mary's gonna have an answer for you. Let's listen.
Okay. All right. I give up. You're right. We're lost. I've been trying to figure out where we are for the past 3 hours. I think I got off from the construction map back in Corinth. It's just They closed off our normal exit for construction, and then that guy cut us off, and he waved at us like he was an accident, and he was sorry, but he wasn't sorry. He did it on purpose, Mary.
Hey, it's okay. We're gonna make it there.
Yeah, you're right. It's just really hard. I mean, you're having God's own son. That's a lot of responsibility. Do you ever think of saying no?
Well, of course I did. Don't you think having God's own son doesn't scare me? I mean, what if we lose him at the festival when he gets older? But I said yes because I trust God and I trust what he has for me. So that's what obedience is.
Yeah, you're right. As long as God is with us, we'll have the strength to do this. Come on, let's go find that beet farmer a few miles back and figure out where we are.
Oh, so that's why they agreed to all this. Because she wanted to be obedient to God.
Yeah, and when you trust God with your life, the natural outcome is that you obey him. That makes sense.
Exactly. And whether it's accepting Mary and Joseph accepting raising Jesus, or you following God in your own lives, we all have to trust and obey him. Look, we've got a few more stops to make. Let's not waste any time. Let's get back to the Van Lorien. You ready, guys? All right, in our next destination, we're going to meet three very intelligent guys. Here we go.
Oh, what was that?
Yeah, that didn't sound good.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh? What do you mean, uh-oh?
It seems our flux capacitor's gone kaput.
What does that mean?
It means we're stuck in the past.
Wow, wasn't that skit fun? Let's see how that's going to tie into our lesson today. We're going to find that out by looking at our kits. Parents are going to have these and they'll help you with working it out. Inside, you're going to see a little stocking. And inside the stocking, you're going to have your 4 days of crafts. And then your parents are going to be able to use this little packet that's going to talk you through it. The only thing that you really kind of need to know on this part, it's self-explanatory, but you'll see there's a little QR code. That, all you have to do is use your camera phone or your phone on your camera and you scan it, and it's going to take you to a website that will either tell the story or sing a song, something like that. Then in there, you'll have a scripture memory that you can show your kids. And there's a few little goodies and fun stuff for the kids. I'm not going to show that. We'll keep that a secret and then get to open it up and look at it. That's really all you need to know. This is your kit. If you have any questions, you can message me at robin@fbcazel.org. Thank you.
If you're just tuning in and don't have a VBS Kids Kit and would like to get the activities, then just go to www.fbcazel.org/VBS. You can find all the activities there.